Recently, Government of India launched a scheme called the National Digital Health Identity Card. So identity number, like the Aadhaar number, every Indian citizen will have a National Digital Health Identity Number, which essentially gives access to the medical history of the person who wants to have this number. Well, it is now voluntary. We will not know what or how will it be in future. It may be mandatory. So as a citizen of India, you're supposed to understand what does it mean to you and me? What does it mean to the people? What does it mean to the society at large? The idea is to create a digital storehouse of or digital source of all Indians, the health data of all Indians. For instance, you want to go to an hospital. You normally we have to take all the old health records. For children like you, it may not be a big issue because you might not have come across any health elements. But as you grow up in age, you will go to doctors, hospitals, use medicines, undergo diagnostics tests a number of times. That all form part of your medical history. Suddenly, someone develops any problem. They may not take this entire medical history with them. Some of them may not even manage the or maintain the medical records also. But medical history is critical for assessment by the doctors. Sometimes some hospitals do not even share the medical records with the patient. They'll simply give the prescription and give a card. And if you want, if you come next time, show us the card, we'll give you the medical file. Or else you pay more money to get the medical file. So therefore, this new national digital health identity card, identity number, will give you a 14-digit number. Perhaps there will be an interface through an app. So once you type this number, your entire medical history will be there. All your earlier health ailments and your visits to doctors, your diagnostic test reports, medicines you have used, the diseases one has developed. So everything will be recorded in the digital database. So you can simply go to any hospital with just your 14-digit national digital health identity number. It sounds quite interesting, obviously. Well, you don't need to maintain your digital health record. You don't need to maintain your health file, health records. And it helps the doctors to accurately diagnose, because history of previous ailments is critical for assessing the current ailment. So sometimes you may not even take the file with you also, assuming that it may not be required. So therefore, the doctor loses the critical link. This is the critical link in the diagnosis. So therefore, a database that covers the earlier tests, earlier treatments, earlier diseases, earlier medicines taken, and doctor consultation, everything, it will be your medical history at on a fingertip. So it becomes very easy also, assuming that you move from one place to other. Suppose I'm staying in Hyderabad, I go to Delhi, and I have not imagined that I'll fall sick in Delhi. So I may not have carried my medical file with me. Who will carry the entire medical records with you unless you're a chronic patient? So you go to Delhi and suddenly fall sick. And you will not have access to your own medical file. And you join a hospital there, the doctor will ask you, what's your previous history? Have you earlier developed any such similar ailments? You really don't know. But once you have this kind of a digital database, of all the medical records of any individual who joins in this, it is very easy. You can simply, the doctor in Delhi can simply type the 14-digit number and he'll get to know your medical history. Finally, you can be in New York also. So it sounds quite interesting. There's no doubt about it. It sounds quite stylish also. But what are its implications? Today, for example, the Hindu wrote an editorial on the ID card. Times of India, I think, subject to correction, published an article by very renowned Dr. Devi Shetty. And several newspapers are writing about it. It's a very interesting technological initiative. From a technocratic point of view, it sounds quite interesting. As a student of engineering, you'll be amused to see this kind of a digital database. But the problem comes is, you should look at the issue from a social science point of view. From a technical point of view, more or less, there's absolutely no problem. The data seamlessly flows from hospitals to hospitals, doctors to doctors, pharma companies to pharma companies, so that there will be a complete data flow. But there are significant concerns. The critics raise significant concerns. One concern is the privacy of the data. My medical history will be known to someone else. So my their medical history will be accessible to someone else. So this is the first issue, the privacy issue. Supreme Court, in famous verdict called Puttuswamy verdict, stated that privacy is fundamental right. The right to life encompasses right to privacy. Right to life encompasses right to health, Supreme Court in its earlier verdict said. So right to health encompasses right to life. Right to life encompasses right to privacy. So therefore, privacy is the fundamental right. But in our country, there's a very little awareness of the importance of the right to privacy also. You just don't bother. Wherever, whenever somebody asks your private data, you simply give your name, phone number, everything, your caste, religion, demographics, simply type and give it, okay, kya hota mera private data, what is there in it? But this data is used by the big business houses to develop marketing strategies. The data is used by advertisers to intrude into your domain. You might have noticed, if you regularly order Swiggy or Zomato, whenever you watch any YouTube video, you'll get Swiggy and Zomato advertisements. Suppose you have served for some hotels, addresses. Next time you open your Google or YouTube or a website, you will get the ads related to hotels. How is it possible? How does Google know that you are looking for hotels or you are looking for Zomato or Swiggy? Because the Google captures your data. And Google captures your browsing history. Google captures your GPS locations. Google captures your personal data, which you are given for opening a Gmail or something else. So all that is used by algorithms to deliver you targeted advertisements. So therefore, data is very important. In the modern economy, data is considered as the new oil. As oil is very important for the world economy, data is going to become a very important source. So Israel negotiated the early shipment of Pfizer's vaccine from the United States by bargaining with the company that we will supply you the entire clinical data of the patients of Israel. So that was a bargaining chip of Israel. So therefore, privacy is a critical component of the modern thinking on human rights, modern thinking on civil rights. That's the first challenge with the national digital database, because your private data about the medicines you have used, test you have undergone, doctors you have consulted, your medical ailments will be known and accessible to someone. The second problem is insurance companies may design policies suiting their interest, because once they know the health profile of the people, they will obviously design costly policies with higher premium. So it helps the insurance companies at the cost of ordinary Indians. Then the third problem is medical, pharma, and research companies may also use this data to only focus on the problems of the wealthier people, because the pharma companies want to develop medicines which the upper class and the wealthier sections need, because that's where the market is. There's very little research to find a cure for diarrhea, though diarrhea is killing lakhs of children across the world every day. So because diarrhea is a poor man's burden, health burden, so they're not bothered about it, because a poor man doesn't have the buying capacity, purchasing capacity. So the fear is, once this profiling takes place of Indians, health profiling of Indians, pharma companies, medical and R&D companies may shift their resources away from the common man to cater to the exclusive needs of the wealthier sections of society. So these are concerns. There may be many such concerns. So there should be a complete, thorough discussion on the merits and demerits of a digital health ecosystem. I've explained to you the advantages of such a digital health ecosystem, and there can be disadvantages of it.